Dear students, we shall learn phrase structure grammar or PS grammar now. As I have told you, phrase structure grammar has evolved from immediate constituent analysis or IC analysis. So let us focus on phrase structure grammar. Phrase structure grammar, also known as PS grammar. It is a model of grammar proposed by Noam Chomsky in his work Syntactic Structures. It's a model of grammar proposed by Noam Chomsky in his work Syntactic Structures. So what is the purpose of such a model of grammar? Just like IC analysis, it helps us in analyzing the syntax of a sentence. So every sentence is a string of linguistic elements. Every sentence is a string of linguistic elements. As we all know, morphemes combine together to form words, and words combine together to form phrases, and phrases join together to constitute a sentence. So the analysis of each of the constituent element in a string, in a sentence, this is made possible by way of phrase structure grammar or PS grammar. So how is it possible? They do it with the help of certain rules called rewrite rules. So the analysis of the constituent elements in a linguistic sentence, in a string, it is done with the help of rewrite rules or replacement rules. So what is rewrite rule or replacement rule? You might remember learning small equations in maths like this. You can represent it like this, x plus x is equal to 2x, or the other way, 2x is equal to x plus x. So whatever you find here on the left hand side can be rewritten in another way in the right hand side. See, 2x, it is seen towards the left hand side, and it is rewritten in another way in the right hand side. Similarly, a sentence can be represented in another way using rewrite rules. See, look at this. This is a simple rewrite rule. S is equal to NP plus VP. S is equal to NP plus VP. So what is S? S refers to the sentence. NP refers to the noun phrase and VP refers to the verb phrase. So take for example the previous sentence. Poor John ran away. Poor John ran away. So what is the S there? S is the sentence, poor John ran away. That is a string of linguistic elements. And it can be rewritten in this way, noun phrase plus verb phrase. So how do you rewrite that? Poor John ran away. Poor John ran away. So here, poor John constitutes the NP. NP or the noun phrase. And ran away constitutes the verb phrase. Is it clear to you? Poor John ran away. This is the noun phrase because noun comes here. And again, ran away is the verb phrase here. You find the verb. So this is a simple example of a rewrite rule or a replacement rule. So, using these rewrite rules, you can understand how morphemes combine together to form words and words combine together to form phrases, and finally how sentences are constituted by a combination of all these. So, it's a step-by-step analysis. So, if you represent the phrase structure grammar analysis of a sentence in a pictographic way, in a pictorial way, then you can call it, it looks like a tree. It's like a tree diagram. Okay. So it is called a phrase marker or P marker. So I'm rubbing this. So the pictorial representation of the analysis of the syntax of a sentence in PS grammar is called a phrase marker or a P marker. So for the exam, they may give you a sentence. and they may ask you to write down the phrase marker of the sentence or the P marker of the sentence. It means nothing but the diagrammatic representation of the syntax of the given sentence. So how are we supposed to do that? So in order to learn how to do phrase marker of a given sentence, you should learn the basic rewrite rules. So the first one I have already explained, S is equal to NP plus VP. And then can we split a noun phrase further? Yes, you can do that. A noun phrase can be split further by writing like this. A noun phrase is constituted by the combination of a determiner and a noun. For example, my book. My is a determiner and book is a noun. Or the man, the article, it is a determiner. And then man, it's a noun. So every noun phrase can be split further and it can be represented with the help of such a rewrite rule or such a replacement rule. Look, noun phrase is equal to a determiner plus a noun. And then what about this one? Verb phrase. It can also be rewritten or using a rewrite or a replacement rule. How can you rewrite a verb phrase? Yeah, it may be like this. A basic rewrite rule of a verb phrase goes like this. Verb phrase is equal to, or it is rewritten like this, auxiliary verb plus main verb plus a noun phrase. Auxiliary verb plus main verb plus a noun phrase. For example, is singing a song. So here is an auxiliary verb, then sing, that is a main verb, and then a song together constitutes a short noun phrase. Is that clear to you? So is singing a song is a verb phrase. See, is singing a song is a verb phrase, and when I am splitting it and rewriting that using a replacement rule or a rewrite rule, I get it like this: auxiliary plus verb plus noun phrase. Here the auxiliary is singing. Here sing constitutes a main verb and a song is a noun phrase. And can you split the noun phrase further? Yes, you can split it further. How do we split it? Determiner plus noun. A article, it is a determiner, and noun, song is a noun. So I hope this is clear to you. How can you rewrite a verb phrase? Yeah, this is one way of rewriting. Sometimes if the sentence is longer, you can of course add like a PP. PP is a prepositional phrase. A prepositional phrase. For example, is singing a song in the park or something like that. In the park or in the party or whatever. Just giving an example. So here, this is a prepositional phrase. So here, in, it's a preposition again. And again here, the party, again an NP. The party. You got another noun phrase there. And if you are further dividing the party, you will get determiner plus noun. Sorry, determiner plus noun. That is, the is a determiner and party is a noun. So I hope this is clear to you. There are a little more points to be explained. I'll show you a diagram and let you know how to do it. So now basically you need to know that a sentence can be rewritten using a rewrite rule or a replacement rule. Sentence is equal to noun phrase plus a verb phrase. A noun phrase can be rewritten as a determiner plus a noun, and a verb phrase can be rewritten as an auxiliary plus a verb and a noun phrase. In some other cases there may be a prepositional phrase as well. അതുണ്ടാവണമെന്ന് നിർബന്ധമില്ല. ചിലപ്പോൾ ഒരു പ്രപ്പസിഷണൽ ഫ്രേസും കൂടെ ഉണ്ടാവും, ചിലപ്പോൾ അതുണ്ടാവണമെന്നില്ല. ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ശ്രദ്ധിക്കുക. ഈ സിംഗിങ് എ സോങ് എന്നാണെങ്കിൽ ഇസ് ഇസ് ദ ഓക്സിലറി, സിംഗിങ് സിംഗ് ഇസ് എ മെയിൻ വേർബ് ആൻഡ് എ സോങ് ഇസ് എ നൗൺ ഫ്രേസ്. ദിസ് എ സോങ് നൗൺ ഫ്രേസ് ക്യാൻ ബി ഫർദർ സ്പ്ലിറ്റ് ഇൻ ടു ഡിറ്റർമിനർ ആൻഡ് നൗൺ. ഏ ആണ് അവിടുത്തെ ഡിറ്റർമിനർ, സോങ് ഒരു നൗൺ ആണ്. അതുപോലെ ചില സെന്റൻസസ് ലെങ്തി ആണെങ്കിൽ ഇറ്റ് മേ ഓൾസോ ഹാവ് എ പ്രപ്പസിഷണൽ ഫ്രേസ്, ലൈക്ക് ഇൻ ദ പാർട്ടി. എവിടെയാണ് പാട്ട് പാടിയത്? ഇൻ ദ പാർട്ടി. അപ്പോൾ ഇൻ ഇസ് എ പ്രപ്പസിഷൻ ആൻഡ് ദ പാർട്ടി. It becomes another noun phrase which can be further divided as determiner and noun. A is a determiner and party is the noun. സോ ഇത്തരം റീറൈറ്റ് റൂൾസ് ഉപയോഗിച്ച് നമുക്കൊരു സെന്റൻസിന്റെ സിൻടാക്സിനെ പഠിക്കാൻ പറ്റും. സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് നോൺ ആസ് ഫ്രേസ് സ്ട്രക്ചർ ഗ്രാമർ ആൻഡ് ദേ ഡു ഇറ്റ് ബൈ ദ ആപ്ലിക്കേഷൻ ഓഫ് റീറൈറ്റ് റൂൾസ് ഓർ റീപ്ലേസ്മെന്റ് റൂൾസ്. സോ ഫോർ ദ എക്സാം യു ഹാവ് ടു റൈറ്റ് ദീസ് ത്രീ ഓക്കെ ആൻഡ് ദെൻ ഇൻ പേജ് നമ്പർ 113, 114, 115, and 116 you will get the elaborate explanation of all these. And in page number 114, they have shown clearly how do we rewrite or how do we apply each rewrite rule to write the structure of a sentence fully. See, in page number 114 in your textbook, S is equal to NP plus VP, 1, rule, rewrite rule number 1. Then, NP is equal to determiner plus noun, rewrite rule number 2. Then in page number 115, you see VP is equal to verb plus noun phrase. That is rule number 3. Then applying all these together, you will get, see, sentence is equal to determiner plus noun plus verb plus noun phrase. What a simple rewrite rule. What a simple sentence in a rewrite rule. So I hope this is clear to you. Now finally, we will get the final string. And if you try to divide further, you will not be able to do that. But the final string that you get at the end of the phrase structure way of analysis, this is called a terminal string. So, the possible all splitting analysis final string, we call it as a terminal string, which is not further divisible. Okay? This is called the terminal string, that is the stage at which the morphophonemic rules are applied to replace symbols by morphemes or words. அதே பின்ன நம்ம டிவைட் ചെയ്യാஞ்சா நமக்கு ചെറിയ morphemes ஐட்டம் ചെറിയ phonemes ஐட்டம் மாத்திரம் நமக்கு அதனை டிவைட் ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുള്ളൂ. அப்போ as I told you, the representation of the structural analysis of a sentence through PS grammar method can be done in a diagrammatic way, which is known as phrase marker or P marker. So in the next video, I'll be showing you how to do the phrase marker or P marker of a sentence. Thank you. Dear students, here is a diagram demonstrating how a sentence can be analyzed. We call it a phrase marker or a P marker. So the representation of the structure of a sentence is called the phrase marker or P marker. The usual form of a P marker is a tree with labeled nodes. See, these are called nodes, N-O-D-E. We label them as NP, VP, determiner, etc. They are all nodes. And the PS rules that generate its constituent structure are sentence is equal to noun phrase plus verb phrase. Sentence is equal to noun phrase plus verb phrase. And again, another rewrite rule is noun phrase is equal to determiner plus noun. Noun phrase is constituted by a combination of determiner and noun. Then the verb phrase is constituted by the main verb plus two noun phrases. And see, if you analyze the sentence, my brother gave my son a book. So here we are doing the phrase marker of the sentence. So here my is a determiner, brother is a noun. So determiner plus noun together constitutes the noun phrase, that is written as the node is NP. Then see, gave my son a book. Gave my son a book. Here you have main verb gave, then plus my son. This is one NP and a book is another NP. And the NP is represented using the rewrite rule determiner plus noun constitute the NP my son. And here there is another NP, a book. In that also you can find determiner plus noun. Thus we get the NP a book. So I repeat, how do we get the verb phrase? Sorry. Gave my son a book. This is the main verb phrase or VP. See this? This constitutes the main verb phrase or VP. Gave my son a book. Inside this verb phrase, we have the main verb gave and then two noun phrases. See, one noun phrase is my son, another noun phrase is a book. So the noun phrase my son is rewritten using determiner plus noun is the noun phrase my book. Then here also a book is another noun phrase. How do we write it? Determiner plus noun, you get a noun phrase. And together verb plus noun phrase 1 plus noun phrase 2, you get the main verb phrase. And together NP plus VP, we get the sentence. Hope you understand. So each of these is called a node. So see, NP is split into two other constituents. So every node from where you can find other constituents, it's called a branching node. So NP is a branching node because it can be split into two branches, namely determiner and noun. Why is NP called a branching node? Because this node can be split into two branches, determiner and noun. Every node in a tree where there is a branch is called a branching node. And one without any branch is called a non-branching node. See, determiner, namukku adine iniyum branch cheyan pattilla. So this is a non-branching node. Okay. So VP, this is a branching node because it can be split into main verb plus noun phrase 1 and noun phrase 2. So this is an example of a branching node. അത് അവിടെ അവസാനിക്കുന്നില്ല അല്ലെ. ഈ ബ്രാഞ്ചിങ് നോഡ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ ഇതിനെയും സ്പ്ലിറ്റ് ആക്കാൻ നമുക്ക് സാധിക്കും, അത് അവിടെ എൻഡ് ചെയ്യുന്നില്ല. ദെർഫോർ ഇറ്റ്സ് ഓൾസോ നോൺ ആസ് നോൺ ടെർമിനൽ നോഡ്. ദെർഫോർ ഇറ്റ്സ് ഓൾസോ നോൺ ആസ് നോൺ ടെർമിനൽ നോഡ്. ഓക്കെ. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഇനിയും ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റില്ല എന്നുള്ളത് നമ്മൾ നോൺ ബ്രാഞ്ചിങ് നോഡ് എന്നാണ് പറയുന്നത്. നമുക്കറിയാം ബ്രാഞ്ചിന്റെ അർത്ഥം എന്താണ്. സോ എ ബ്രാഞ്ചിങ് നോഡ് ഇസ് എ നോഡ് വിച്ച് ക്യാൻ ബി സ്പ്ലിറ്റ് ഫർദർ ഇൻ ടു കോൺസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂൻ പാർട്സ് ഓഫ് ബ്രാഞ്ചസ്. Noun phrase and verb phrase both are examples of branching nodes. But see, determiner and noun, they are non-branching nodes. Because that is why we can't divide them. So, that is non-branching node. There is another name. This branching node is called the branch side. That is why we can't do it. Branching node is called non-terminal node. Terminal node. That's another name for branching node. ആ പേര് കേൾക്കുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ വരും ഇത് ബ്രാഞ്ച് ചെയ്തെടുക്കാൻ പറ്റും. അത് ടെർമിനൽ അല്ല, അത് അവസാനത്തേതല്ല, ഇനിയും അത് ബ്രാഞ്ച് ചെയ്യാൻ സാധിക്കും. ദെർഫോർ വി കോൾ ഇറ്റ് എ നോൺ ടെർമിനൽ നോഡ്. ആൻഡ് ഇവിടെ നോൺ ബ്രാഞ്ചിങ് നോഡ് ഉണ്ടല്ലോ, ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞു നോൺ ബ്രാഞ്ചിങ് നോഡ്. ഡിറ്റർമിനർ ഒരു നോൺ ബ്രാഞ്ചിങ് നോഡാണ്, ഡിറ്റർമിനർ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് കണ്ടോ. ഡിറ്റർമിനർ നോൺ ബ്രാഞ്ചിങ് നോഡാണ്, അത് ഇനിയും സ്പ്ലിറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റില്ല. അപ്പൊ അത് അവസാനത്തേതാണ്. ദെർഫോർ വി കോൾ ഇറ്റ് എ ടെർമിനൽ നോഡ്. ദെർഫോർ വി കോൾ ഇറ്റ് എ ടെർമിനൽ No. So today we have learned how to do the phrase marker or P marker of a given sentence. My brother gave my son a book. So nammal ithrayum rewrite rules unda. S is equal to NP plus VP, basic rewrite rule aanu. NP is equal to determiner plus noun, vera rewrite rule aanu. VP is equal to verb plus noun phrase. Noun phrase 1 undava, noun phrase 2 undava. Appo ee rewrite rules use cheyide enganeyaanu ee sentence inde phrase marker ezhuthiyenna nammal ippo kandathu. We also learned what are branching nodes and non branching nodes. Another name for branching node is non terminal node. Another name for non branching node is terminal node. So keep your textbook with you as you listen to my class. Thank you. Dear students, today we have learned IC analysis and PS grammar, which evolved out of IC analysis, and we also learned how to do the phrase marker of a given sentence. And now this audio clip is about the limitations or the drawbacks of PS grammar. There are 6 points given in page number 116. It's very easy to understand. Point number 1, PS grammar is inadequate to show the relationship between sentences, like the relationship between simple sentences, compound sentences and complex sentences. It does not show any relationship between the active passive sentence relations and affirmative, negative, etc. Itrulu PS grammar can help us understand the structure of a sentence or what is within a sentence. Okay, the syntax within a sentence can be explained with the help of PS grammar, but the relationship between two or more sentences cannot be explained using this method. Then point number 2, discontinuous constituents cannot be accommodated by PS rules. Will you sing a song? As an example, they have given here, will you sing a song? This is an example of a discontinuous constituent. See, in this sentence, will and sing, you find that the auxiliary will
appears before the word you, and then the main verb sing appears in that question. See, if it was a normal sentence, then you will say like this: I will sing a song. In that sentence, will sing goes together. They go together. Will and sing, the auxiliary verb and the main verb, they are close by and they go together. Therefore, it's easy to divide and explain. But in the given sentence, will you sing a song? What happened? The auxiliary and the main verb, they are quite far away from each other, because in between them you find you. So they are not close by each other. So we call them discontinuous constituents. Such discontinuous constituents cannot be explained properly with the help of a PS grammar. Point number 3. PS grammar will not help us to understand ambiguities. What do you mean by ambiguity? It means uncertainty with regard to meaning. The ambiguity can come in two ways: lexical ambiguity or structural ambiguity. What do you mean by lexical ambiguity? A word having more than one meaning. A word with the same spelling and pronunciation but with different meaning. We have learned that. Like with words like bat, bank, etc. Bank can either mean the shore of a river or the institution where you do money transactions. Then bat, it can either mean the toy with which you play or the flying mammal, the bird, bat. So this is an example of lexical ambiguity. So in a given sentence, you cannot explain which one was intended. PS grammar will not help you to understand which particular noun was intended there. So such ambiguities cannot be explained properly using PS grammar. And again, structural ambiguity. They have given a sentence like old men and women. So we are confused as to whether it is like men alone are old or both men and women are old. Again, flying planes can be dangerous. We are confused as to whether the act of flying planes is dangerous or whether those planes which are flying are dangerous. So that is an example of structural ambiguity. In the structure, engane split cheyadu explain cheyanam namukku ariyadu varum. Idile edu arthamaanu uddeshichu ariyadu varum. So athram ambiguities ne explain cheyan PS grammar nu pattilla. Then point number 4. The close relationship between the verb and the particle in phrases like call off, take off, etc. cannot be shown by PS rules. Call off, take off போலുള്ള two part verbs ഉണ്ടല്ലോ. അപ്പം phrasal verbs അങ്ങനത്തെ relationship എങ്ങനെയാണ് explain ചെയ്യാനായിട്ട് PS rule പറ്റില്ല. Take the hat off എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോഴേക്കും take off ഒന്നിച്ചല്ല വന്നേക്കുന്നത്. Take-ന്റെയും off-ന്റെയും ഇടയ്ക്ക് ദ ഹാറ്റ് എന്നുള്ള വേർഡ് വന്നു. അതാണ് പറഞ്ഞാൽ വീണ്ടും അവിടെ ഒരു ഡിസ്കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് ആയി വരികയാണ്. അപ്പോൾ അങ്ങനത്തെ ടു പാർട്ട് ഫ്രേസൽ വേർബ്സ് ഒക്കെ എക്സ്പ്ലെയിൻ ചെയ്യാനായിട്ടും സ്പ്ലിറ്റ് ചെയ്യാനായിട്ടും പ്രയാസം വരും. ദെൻ പോയിന്റ് നമ്പർ 5. ദ പ്രോപ്പർട്ടി ഓഫ് റിക്കേഴ്ഷൻ, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ പ്രോസസ് ബൈ വിച്ച് വി കൻ ഗോ ഓൺ ജോയിനിങ് സെന്റൻസസ് കെ നോട്ട് ബി അക്കൗണ്ടഡ് ഫോർ പി എസ് ഗ്രാമർ. അപ്പോൾ ചിലപ്പം ഈ ലിറ്ററേച്ചറിലും അല്ലെങ്കിൽ കണക്റ്റഡ് സ്പീച്ചിലും ഒക്കെ ഒത്തിരി സെന്റൻസസ് ഇങ്ങനെ കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് ആയിട്ട് വരില്ലേ. അപ്പോൾ അങ്ങനെ ഒരു ഒരു ലോങ് വൈൻഡഡ് സെൻറ്റൻസസ് ഒക്കെ വരുമ്പോഴത്തേക്കും അതൊന്നും ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്ത് കാണിക്കാൻ പി എസ് ഗ്രാമറിന് പറ്റില്ല. ദെൻ പോയിന്റ് നമ്പർ 6. സ്റ്റൈലിസ്റ്റിക് വേരിയേഷൻസ് കനോട്ട് ബി അക്കൗണ്ടഡ് ഫോർ പി എസ് ഗ്രാമർ. സാം സെൽഡം വിസിറ്റ്സ് മീയും സെൽഡം ഡസ് സാം വിസിറ്റ്സ് മീയും രണ്ടും സെമാൻറ്റിക്കലി ഒരേ അർത്ഥങ്ങളാണ്. സെമാൻറ്റിക്കലി ഓർ with regard to the meaning of these two sentences, we can say safely that they mean the same thing, but the style of saying the fact is different. One person may say Sam seldom visits me, another person may say seldom does Sam visit me. So these are called stylistic variations. Appo itharam stylistic variations ne explain cheyanam accommodate cheyanam PS grammar nu pattunnilla. Adana vera oru problem. Appo itrayum 6 limitations of PS grammar are enlisted in page number 116. You have to memorize those limitations of PS grammar. Adupol thanne people may ask you, university exam, for the university exam they may ask you in page number 114, what is the advantage of PS grammar over IC analysis or IC model. In page number 114, last sentence, phrase structure grammars have an advantage over the IC model in that the labels are inbuilt in the rewrite rules. Appam ee rewrite rules thanne ore labels unde, id engenaana label edu node edu ponda annalathu, and can be arranged in a sequence so that each rule can be used to rewrite the output of the previous one. ഇത്ര നിങ്ങൾ എഴുതിയാൽ നിങ്ങൾ ആ റീറൈറ്റ് റൂൾസ് 1, 2, 3 എന്ന് എഴുതി കാണിച്ചിട്ട് അതെങ്ങനെയാണ് ഒരു സെന്റൻസിൽ അപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുന്നത് എഴുതി കാണിച്ചിട്ട് പറഞ്ഞാൽ മതി. ദീസ് ലേബിൾസ് ആർ ഇൻബിൽറ്റ് ഇൻ ദ റീറൈറ്റ് റൂൾസ്. സോ വി കൻ അറേഞ്ച് ദ റീറൈറ്റ് റൂൾസ് ഇൻ എ സീക്വൻസ് ആൻഡ് ദസ് ഗെറ്റ് ആൻ ഔട്ട്പുട്ട്. ആ ഒരു എക്സാമ്പിൾസ് ഇവിടെ കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ട്, ആ റീറൈറ്റ് റൂൾസ് എങ്ങനെ അപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുന്നതെന്നുള്ളത് ഞാൻ കാണിച്ചു തന്നല്ലോ, അതങ്ങ് എഴുതിയാൽ മതി. ഐ ഹോപ്പ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ക്ലിയർ ടു യു.